What's up, guys? We're here with another Mat Chat with Coach Corey. This time we are talking about sparring tips. So Coach Corey is going to give you some of his favorite sparring tips and probably some sparring etiquette as well.
Yeah, definitely. So guys, when it comes to sparring, there's a lot of factors at play. But there's some things you can do to ensure you have a good spar and that you have a successful spar. I don't ever like to say a win or a lose spar, because sparring, you don't win or lose. You just do better or you do worse, but you never lose, right?
Both people should win.
Right. Both people should theoretically win, and both people should actually theoretically be learning. It's a learning experience. It's just a fun one. So guys, one of the first things I always like to say during sparring is like, keep your hands up, okay? I know that's probably redundant by now. I know Coach Forrest says that, I say that, everyone says that, but keep your hands up. At first, you know, we'll have a tendency to put our hands down and whatnot, and that can happen as we spar more. Let's say we're doing 2, 3, 4 rounds. Well, now, throughout the rounds, your hands might start dipping down, your head movement might be sharper, but at the beginning of spar, you're kind of going in like a cold car engine, right? You don't want to start off with the low hands and the head movement. Keep your hands up, be safe, protect your head, protect your jaw. That's number one, right? Everything else can be modified after, but keep your hands up first, okay? That's important. Next thing is really focus on fundamentals, okay? I know me, like even back in the day, like I'd go on YouTube and now it's the thing is Instagram, and everyone wants to try the crazy techniques and all the fancy things. But guys, like the things that will work for you in a spar and things that you can do consistently in a spar are going to be your jab cross, you know, checking your leg kicks, throwing your round kick, doing things like that, okay? As you go on and as you get better and you get more of your sparring legs, so to say, now you can start switching it up and be more playful, but at first you should be able to rep these fundamental techniques, like your jab cross, your hooks, your rear kicks. Those are things you should be able to throw in a spar and not have to difficult all the time doing, yeah. Right? Like that should be natural.
With all the techniques that there are out there in the world, people still get knocked out by the simple jab cross.
That is correct. You know, I'll even give him a little shout out of a student here, Raphael. He was a big kicker. He loved to kick before in sparring, but he was a little too kick heavy. And I said, hey man, like learn to box a little bit more, learn to use your hands a little bit more. If you got the hands, the fundamental hands to make me worry, then your kicks are all going to land. And sure enough, now in sparring, he's doing a lot of boxing and landing a lot of kicks on people now. It's like you can use the fundamentals to set up the fancier, set up those more traditional techniques. So yeah, just get those fundamentals out there. Rep. Another thing is when there is someone coaching, like a senior student or myself, because there'll be days where I just sit out sparring and I'm just coaching you guys. I know it's going to sound funny and simple enough, but listen. So a lot of people, and this is a fact, I've experienced this, many of my students have experienced this, but when you're sparring or in any sort of fight or flight, if you're not used to it, you get the earmuff sound, okay? And it sounds like you have seashells over your ears. And it can be hard to actually listen to me coach. The best thing I can say is just try to open those ears up and don't ignore what I'm saying. Just listen to it and be like a robot. In it goes. And then, you know, out comes a result, right? If I yell jab, jab, cross, throw that jab, jab, cross. I'm seeing that you can land it for a reason, right? That's a huge thing, I think, especially for anyone interested eventually in competing, is just being able to listen to someone while your adrenaline is spiking and you can almost hear your heartbeat in your ear. You know, like, listen to your coach, listen to your senior student, and you will find the promised land.
And that's just good for situational awareness too, self-defense. Absolutely. Do you know what else is going on around
you? Yeah, are you aware of everything, not just what's in front of you, but what's around you, right? It's very important to keep that in mind. And the other thing is, you know, I always like to say it's more etiquette than anything, but only go as hard and difficult as you want, okay? So we're all different here. We're all looking to get certain things out of training and sparring. Now, if I have someone that wants to go on a more lighter sparring, guys, I'm not going to hit them hard, okay? I know that sounds, again, funny or simple, but like a lot of people, hey, I'm going to do light, and then they get cracked with a round kick, and they're like, what do I do? It's just like, no, tell your partner. If you need it lighter, you say, hey, bring it down just a little bit. I'm not looking to go hard today. And then, oh, if you're the person that's like, oh, well, I want to go harder, well, find a partner around the room that wants to go harder, and you'll have that as well, right? But at the end of the day, you want to be a supportive teammate. You want to make sure you're never making someone feel like they're just getting bullied and beat down. You want them to learn from this experience. So you can give them some troubles without putting on too much heat, okay, so to say. So that's another thing. Just really make sure you're communicating with your sparring partner, because can't spar if you don't have no sparring partners.
Yeah. And I also, like, to me, I have the philosophy that you should be able to train with anybody. You know,
absolutely.
I spar with my wife, no problem, because I can bring that intensity down. And there are some people that you can learn a ton from.
Absolutely.
But you could also probably overpower just by your weight. Like,
yeah.
You know, most women are going to be half my size. And so I could just overpower them. But technique-wise, they might be, you know, they might have some tricks up their sleeve that
absolutely.
I'm not going to get if they don't want to spar with me because I go too hard.
You know, and then also, guys, just as a thought, you know, this can, I guess, go as part of more of that etiquette as well. You can have certain objectives when you spar, okay? So, like, let's say I am with someone that's newer to the game that might be a little bit scared of sparring. Well, hey, I'll work my defense that round. I'll work my footwork. I'll work my blocks. I'll let them land on me, because at the end of the day, guys, if you are more experienced, you gain nothing from beating down a newbie. You gain nothing but maybe a big ego in your head. You know, be the helpful, you know, helpful teammate. Don't be the bully. Work on those things. Again, you're better than someone a little bit. Work on your defense. You know, if you do want to get some of those harder rounds, look around the room who wants those harder rounds. There's no share of people here that want them as well. You know, I even like those. But again, I even spar with my new students, and they never get hurt. They never leave feeling downtrodden. They leave feeling like they learned something.
I like that.
Yeah.
One question I got for you.
Yeah.
Let's say it's somebody's like first time sparring. They're nervous about sparring. They're watching this video because they haven't sparred yet,
yeah.
And they're nervous. My questions would be, one, what would you recommend to that brand new student? And then two, about how long can they expect before they at least feel comfortable? They don't feel like, I mean, you always get the butterflies in the
yeah.
stomach, but before they, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yes.
When they feel some sort of like, okay, I understand what's going on.
They're content in the situation. Yeah.
Yeah.
So the first thing, guys, is, you know, sparring can be intimidating, but the only way to do it, only way to get past it is to jump into it. Start off by just going with people that you know will take care of you, or, you know, people that aren't too intense. You can always spar with me. Guys, I'm never going to hurt you. I'm always going to make sure you're okay. We have plenty of other students, even our competitors, who, you know, if you request them, hey, can you go light, just kind of do a light round with me, they can absolutely do it. Never feel like if you see a competitor, you have to ask them to spar hard, because they like sparring light too. They gain knowledge from it too. So start off with picking the people you most feel comfortable with. You know, if there's someone that is a little bit intimidating and they want to spar and you're not ready for them yet, you can say, hey, I'm just not ready yet. That's okay. It's not an offensive thing. We'll get to a point where you are ready for them, all right? And then for our second question, can you repeat that actually one more time?
Yeah, yeah. Although actually real quick,
yeah.
Could they come up to you like before a class and just say, hey, if I want to try sparring, but before I spar, can I just not train with this person?
Absolutely, absolutely. Guys, you are in debt to no one to spar with anyone, right? It's supposed to be a fun thing, and if sparring with certain people makes you feel anxiety, you do not have to spar with those certain people. That is okay.
Yeah, so don't be afraid to let him know too, and
yeah.
He can kind of navigate it
for
you. I got
you guys.
And then my second question was, you know, how long can they expect before they feel like they're not sinking?
Definitely. So I'll say for the first month and a half, you're going to feel that head above water feeling, right? You're treading water. That's okay. You're teaching your body not to react in such a extreme way, right? Like, I'm sure right now if you're new sparring, everything makes you flinch, everything makes your heart spike through your neck. Eventually, once you get more rounds in, okay, and you get the experience, not getting hurt, but getting hit, blocking shots, you're gonna not only mentally make that note, but your body physically is gonna make that note. Oh, I can do this and no trauma is gonna come to me. And those anxiety feelings, that fight or flight, is gonna calm down. Eventually, you're just gonna be able to get in there and mix it up with anyone. But
yeah.
Again, it's just gonna come from just time on the mats and time sparring with people. It's funny, but the more you get hit, the less scared you get of getting hit. So it's a funny thing, but keep that in mind.
something that I know one of our members said that you had told her, and it's something I tell people. It's like, usually, first couple times you get hit, you kind of think, oh, ow, that hurt. And then you go, actually, it doesn't really hurt. It just feels like a push. Yeah. It just kind of jolts you. You just weren't expecting it. But you start to like acclimate to that. You're like, okay, yeah. It's surprising.
Your body starts to realize what hurts and what is just a force or
a surprise.
A surprise, I guess. Was I pushed? Was I struck? But you're going to eventually find out, like, wow, just because I get hit on my body, it doesn't necessarily hurt. And you also eventually learn that through how to breathe and sparring. All that comes into play. And it just, again, makes you realize what you can actually do and what you can actually deal with.
I like that. Yeah. And the one little bit of advice I'd also throw out if you're brand new is get your 100 punches out of the way. In other words, what always happens when you first start sparring, there's a very fast learning curve. Like, you'll go out there, you'll be like, I've hit the pads a million times. I don't know why I can't think of what to do when I'm sparring. But you'll get over that really fast. They only last a little bit. It probably takes you about 100 punches to throw before you feel like, okay, I don't feel completely like I have no idea what to do. So get out there, throw the 100 punches, you'll figure out what works, what doesn't, and you'll feel so much better after that first 100 punches. Cool.
Well,
I guess that's us. So bye-bye.